In today's video, we're going to talk about how you can make sure that your rabbit's teeth look like this rather than like this. And so I'm gonna briefly talk to you guys about my rabbit, Oliphant. And the reason that I'm gonna talk to you about him is that he's had some pretty significant dental disease since he's been in my life. We got him when he was really little, a little kit, and he was probably 7 or 8 weeks old. And so we've had him ever since. And I've already showed you him in a couple other videos. As usual, he's adorable and a great help to the channel. So we were working with him towards going from his younger diet to his older diet. It's, you know, somewhat of a transition phase where we're going from mostly alfalfa-based products that have a little higher calcium, a little bit higher calorie content, back to a grass-based diet. Now, this grass-based diet is important, as we'll talk about in a little bit, but the biggest challenge we noticed with him is that even when he was about a year old or even a little bit less, we were starting to see some pretty significant challenges with him eating hay. He would only eat a little bit of hay, he wouldn't eat a lot of hay, and the biggest challenge with that is that no matter how little pellets we fed him, he still would not really eat hay. So I was starting to do a little bit of looking in his mouth, you know, keeping a really close eye on his front teeth. And, you know, his front teeth still looked good at that point, and I was very confused. And eventually they started to have a little bit of a slant similar to this, as you can see in this picture here. This is not him, but it's one that I borrowed from the internet, and the link should be down below. And so I looked at that, and I'm like, you know, there's something's gotta be wrong with his back teeth. So the way the rabbit's teeth work is that they have 6 incisors, and these are the front teeth, and they look like this. They have 2 on the bottom and they have 4 on top, 2 larger and 2 smaller. And then they have some premolars and molars, and there are 6 on top and 5 on the bottom. And we call these cheek teeth, as even the molars and premolars are very similar in their anatomy. Now, the thing with rabbit teeth is that they're constantly growing. They're very rarely sitting static in their size, and they're always going to continually get longer. And this goes for the incisors and for the molars as well. And normally these teeth are worn down through the use of hay. The grass hay usually will break those teeth down, wear down the surface, and keep them at a short height or a normal length for these rabbits. Now, there's some genetic predisposition to some rabbits, no matter what you feed them, no matter what, they just have a bad mouth conformation, and they will get some sort of dental disease associated with this. Now, the common dental problems that we see in rabbits or problems with their teeth include long molars due to insufficient wear, some sort of points that are on the edges of the molars causing trauma to the inside of the mouth, making them not want to chew or eat. A poor diet causing the front teeth to either grow crooked or some sort of genetic thing that causes their teeth to grow incorrectly, and then they don't wear against each other normally. One of the other dental diseases that we see often in rabbits is basically a tooth root abscess, or an abscess underneath the tooth where we get some fluid accumulation and an infection. And this infection can cause some severe problems. The infection can be caused by a lot of things, but including trauma, where if they chew too hard and there's too much crunching between the teeth, it can damage the gums and allow bacteria down to the bottom of the tooth. So what kind of problems did Ollie have, and why did he not want to eat hay? Well, he had kind of a combination of these problems. So it started out with a very long single molar. Now that's a little bit strange to me, and I still don't know exactly why, because despite taking x-rays, we don't have an exact idea of what in his conformation or what in his diet is causing one single tooth to be extra long. And this tooth is the front right premolar, or basically the first cheek tooth on the bottom on the right side. And this tooth was extremely long. So basically I took him into the clinic that I worked at, and we took a look at the front teeth and the back teeth. And at the time, his front teeth looked really good, normal, maybe a little bit long and a little bit of a slant, but otherwise within normal limits. His back teeth, however, showed that we really have some work to do, especially on that single molar that seemed to be what was causing a lot of the issues. Now, what we did is we sedated him, put him under anesthesia, and we took a very high speed dental drill with a special bit that has extra length so you can get all the way back there. And we were able to burr down that tooth. We also straightened out his incisors so that they're within, you know, a normal direction so that we're not chewing crooked. And one of the really important things for you guys, if you have a rabbit with some teeth issues, is make sure that your vet is always checking the front and the back teeth. Because sometimes you can have really overgrown molars and molars with some very severe disease, and the front incisors look normal, and vice versa. So make sure that you're always checking everything in their mouth whenever the vet can. And this can be done with some sort of speculum. I typically will use an otoscope, or a tool that's designed to look in the ear of other animals. And it fits really well back there, gives us the illumination we need. And in most rabbits, I can see almost all of the teeth. To get a really full detailed dental exam, you really do need to go under sedation so that they're more compliant in allowing you to look back there. The other thing that can be really helpful is doing some x-rays. Now, the problem is if we do an x-ray that goes from the top of the head down, it can be really hard to differentiate normal bones and diseased bones because of all of the structures in between. But if you do a lateral, which is going from this side of the head to this side of the head, we basically are able to see all of the teeth pretty well, but you can't differentiate one side or the other very well. Not that you can't, but it can be difficult. So doing some x-rays can be very helpful to diagnose specific diseases and can really give your vet an idea of what's going on in the mouth without as much sedation or without sedation, depending on how compliant your bunny is. So with Ollie, I've ended up having to do a tooth trim just about every month or every 2 months. And I believe that there's something going on with his premolar where it just grows and it doesn't get proper occlusion or proper wearing on the tooth. And so there's not much we can do about it other than try to keep it healthy and promote as much hay consumption as we possibly can. And the more hay consumption that we can promote, the more likely the rabbit is to actually wear down those teeth. And you might be able to go a little bit longer between tooth trims in a rabbit like him, where no matter how much hay he eats, you know, he's still going to probably need some help along the way. Now, one other thing to think about is that your vet may recommend removing an incisor or removing a molar if it's a constant problem. And, you know, this may sound counterintuitive when we want proper wearing, but a lot of times it can get rid of the problem where we have one tooth that just continually will overgrow. And often, especially in the molars, we have multiple teeth that overlap each other tooth during the chewing motion. And if I had a model, I would definitely show you, and I'm hoping to get one here on the channel soon. But that wearing action may actually be better if we have that non-diseased tooth going against a different non-diseased tooth, rather than having a diseased tooth that's not allowing proper wearing. Now, make sure that you guys are finding a good veterinarian for your rabbits, as it can be pretty challenging sometimes. And the one thing to make sure is to make sure that they have experience with rabbit teeth. Some veterinarians really are still in the old school of using hand tools. Now there's a tool called a rongeurs, or basically it looks like a diagonal cutter for wires. And that's been used for a long time to cut rabbit teeth. However, the challenge is that sometimes we will get fractures of the tooth, and that fracture can cause more damage, and it can be very hard to control how much tooth we're actually taking off. And there's also a hand rasp, which is basically a file that was used for rabbit teeth. And I typically don't recommend usage of these either, because it can be really challenging to get proper cutting down of those teeth, and it can be a lot more painful than using a high-speed drill or a high-speed dental drill. So I do recommend using power tools. Even if they are using a Dremel, that can be acceptable as long as they're able to get those back teeth appropriately. The other thing is make sure that you keep a really close eye on your bunny's teeth, especially if they are a problem child like Ollie is, because they can get out of hand really quickly. If you don't pay attention for a month or a month and a half, you know, you may suddenly go back and his teeth are extremely out of whack. And even Ollie is out of whack still. So even though we've kept up with his dentals and keeping his teeth normal shape and size, one of the challenges that we're still dealing with is that his conformation prohibits us from really being able to cure it. So basically, his top teeth are going behind his bottom teeth in the incisors. And the challenge with that is, and the problem with that is that basically we're not gonna get normal wearage, because an underbite isn't supposed to be what we have. It's supposed to be a slight overbite so that we get proper wearing, and he doesn't have that. And there's really no way to fix that. And I don't really know why he has that. It's probably genetic based on breeding. So the other thing is if you are breeding rabbits, making sure that you're selecting for good dental conformation and good dental health for your babies. Thank you guys so much for watching, and hopefully I will keep you updated with Ollie's dental health. And next time I do a dental, I'll try to take some pictures of the before and afters, and so that you guys can get an idea of what we're doing here and what kind of a difference your rabbit's dental health can make. So we will see you guys in the next one. If you have questions, leave them down below, and don't forget to like and subscribe with this video. It really can help out the channel a lot. We'll see you in the next one.